Welcome to our piping engineering channel. In this video, we will learn how to calculate the distance between two elbows in a complex pipe drawing. Before starting this video, please subscribe to our channel to watch more useful videos. This video provides excellent practice information about piping skills, therefore please watch the video till end. Let's start the piping tutorial video. As you can see in this pipeline, there are rotations of both 12.8 degrees horizontally and 13.8 degrees vertically. After these turns, we need to find the distance between the two elbows. Let's first learn the bill of materials of this pipeline. This table contains the list of materials required for the fabrication of the pipeline in this pipe drawing. We see in the second row the items, quantities, sizes and descriptions of the used materials. Let's start learning the materials used in this pipeline. Item number 1 has been used in several places of the pipeline. Let's look at the material list. The item number 1 quantities are 0.9 meters, sizes 8 inch, pipe, seamless, schedule 20, carbon steel, ASTM A106, grade B, ASME B36.10M. Item number 2 has been used in one place of this pipeline. Let's look at the material list. The item number 2 quantities is 1 off, sizes 8 inch, flange, weld neck, 150 class, raised face, schedule 20, carbon steel, ASTM A105, ASME B16.5. Item number 3 has been used in two places of this pipeline. Let's look at the material list. The item number 3 quantities are 2 off, sizes 8 inch, elbow 90 degree, short radius, carbon steel, ASTM A234, grade WPB, schedule 20, ASME B16.2B. We successfully completed to learn the bill of materials in this pipe drawing. Now let's find out in which directions this pipeline is heading. You can see such a diagram in each pipe drawings. This shows the directions. There are 6 directions here. North direction. South direction. East direction. West direction. Up direction. Down direction. The person reading the drawing should imagine himself facing north, provided that he is in the center of these directions. The pipeline starting from this point and extend to the up eastwards. Then pipeline turns first to the southwards, then rotated to east horizontally at angle 12.8 degree, then again rotated to the upwards vertically at angle 13.8 degree. At last pipeline turns to the eastwards at angle 90 degree elbow. During the horizontal and vertical rotations of the pipeline, two right triangles are created from the dashed line. Let's color the horizontal right triangle in red and the vertical right triangle in blue. The perpendicular sides of the horizontal right triangle are 220 and 995 mm as shown in the drawing. One of the perpendicular sides of the vertical right triangle will be 250 mm as shown in the drawing and the other side will be the hypotenuse of the horizontal right triangle. Let's mark the hypotenuse of the horizontal right triangle with the letter H. First, let's find the hypotenuse of the horizontal right triangle. For this one, we will use Pythagorean theorem formula. The square of the hypotenuse of a horizontal right triangle H is equal to 220 squared plus 995 squared. Continue to calculation, the square of hypotenuse is equal 1038425. We continue again, H equals 1038425 under the root. Using scientific calculator we find that H is equal to 1019 millimeters. 1019 is the length of the hypotenuse of the horizontal right triangle and also is one of the perpendicular sides of the vertical right triangle. Let's mark the hypotenuse of the vertical right triangle with the letter L. We will use the Pythagorean theorem formula again to find the length of the hypotenuse of a vertical right triangle. The square of the hypotenuse of a vertical right triangle L is equal to 250 squared plus 1019 squared. Continue to calculation. The square of hypotenuse is equal 1100861. We continue again. L equals 1100861 under the root. Using scientific calculator, we find that L is equal to 1049 millimeters. 1049 is the length of the hypotenuse of the vertical right triangle. Also, 1049 is length distance center to center of elbows, which required to found. By using this method, you can easily calculate distances between the elbows in the any pipe lines. Now let's do all these calculations on the 3D model of the pipeline for easy understand our tutorial video. First, let's find the hypotenuse of the horizontal right triangle again. The square of the hypotenuse of a horizontal right triangle H is equal to 220 squared plus 995 squared. Continue to calculation. The square of hypotenuse is equal 1038425. We continue again. H equals 1038425 under the root. Using scientific calculator, we find that H is equal to 1019 millimeters. 1019 is the length of the hypotenuse of the horizontal right triangle and also is one of the perpendicular sides of the vertical right triangle. We will use the Pythagorean theorem formula again to find the length of the hypotenuse of a vertical right triangle. The square of the hypotenuse of a vertical right triangle L is equal to 250 squared plus 1019 squared. Continue to calculation. The square of hypotenuse is equal 1100861. We continue again. L equals 1100861 under the root. Using scientific calculator, we find that L is equal to 1049 millimeters. 1049 is length distance center to center of elbows, which required to found. This tutorial video is finishing here. If you have any question about video, you can write comments in the comment section. Your ideas will be very interesting for us. You can watch videos about pipe length, pipe slope, pipe fittings, welding symbols by entering the links in the description below of this video. If you liked our video, please subscribe to our piping engineering channel. Your support is very important for us. Let's not miss the comments and likes, my friends. Thank you for watching. See you on next video. Take care.